What we're gonna do right here is go back, way back. Y'all ready for this?
It's the Going Way Back Show with Money B.
Money B.
Your home for classic hip hop, raw and uncut. If you see the glow around me,
yes,
you know I'm feeling real good right about now.
I'm loving those Casellis.
You like them? You like them?
Yes,
shout
sir.
Out to Maxwell.
Maxwell Benson.
Maxwell Info. My man Maxwell just got back from New York, and let me just say, he looked out for you, boy. You know what I'm saying? He got me the fresh ass Casellis. I got to go get my prescriptions put in these things.
Right?
Right away. How y'all like them?
Real deal,
though. Fly, right? You know, and. For those of you who have been following the show, you know that we've been expecting a new addition to the Going Way Back Show crew, and he has arrived.
Yes.
Lord Tariq is here. That's right. That's why the seat of Tantizi is empty right now, but she's definitely here in spirit.
And we love you.
And she's going to be still keeping us in shape, whipping us in shape via text and Skype and all that stuff, you know, while we... get it together. And of course, she's still going to deliver the old school new news. So
definitely.
Don't think you're getting away with it that easy. Tantizi is still
I'm loving those Casellis,
man. The building. So, you know, I got a lot to say. And, you know, another reason I'm really happy because my guest is certain people that you fan out on.
Right.
You feel me? And,
right.
And this is one of the casts that I always did. Brother Jay of X Clan is in the building. That's right. He is here in the flesh. He'll be joining us, and we're just going to talk about everything. It's like, you know, some interviews or some people that you get to talk to, you don't even really have to write a script or whatever, because it's questions that you've been wanting to ask.
Forever.
Since forever.
Right.
You know, it's like, man, I want to ask you this since the very first time
since the first song came out.
Exactly. So I got a lot to talk about with Brother Jay. So... always.
Yes, sir.
You know, enough about me, my brother. What's up with you?
Man, you know, I've been chilling out. I was hanging out with my daughter last week.
Mm-hmm.
She, you know, summer camp had a week off for some reason. I don't know why. So she was hanging with me.
Right.
And we were just, you know, I brought her up here to the show.
Right.
She loved
it. I hope she practicing her line. I taught her how to draw a dope ass line.
She is.
So next time I see her, she better be drawing
a herd.
Is that what lions are? Herds?
A herd.
No, what are lions?
Pride.
A pride.
Pride.
She better be drawing prides of them shits.
Prides.
Oh, fucking pride.
Yes. So, you know, I took her to here,
right.
And I took her to Speedy Show tomorrow. And she actually got to experience some of the Ink Slam. There's Ink Slam going on that just happened on Thursday, Friday, and Saturday last week. And I got to bring her there. My boy called me up on a last-minute whim and was like, dude, can you spin? I was like, cool.
Really?
So, yeah, she was with me, came in, and it just so happened to be the teenage part of the Ink Slam.
Right.
So it was three teenage groups, dope teams. They came with it.
Did she enjoy it?
Yes. Yes. See, opened up her mind.
Well, that's the good thing, because I'm glad that you're able to expose your daughter to the culture.
Yes.
At an early enough age where, obviously, you know, the teenage years is coming, so you're about to go through the bullshit. Let me tell you right now. But at least for these few last years that you got her, you can show her some stuff.
Exactly.
And, you know, like I said, you're going to go through the bullshit for the next 5 or 6 years. But
I'm knowing.
Possibly she'll come back. And some I know some of my friends, their kids just rock with them through the whole thing. Like, remember Metal Man Ace and Kazam?
Exactly.
Sometimes they're that influenced, and they grab a hold of it. So that's all we can hope for.
That's right. How was your weekend?
Well, like I said, I had that baby.
Woo!
So it was a whole bunch of, you know, up all nights.
Oh,
crying.
Man.
I ain't going to take all the credit. You know, Tante,
she had to put it in.
Yeah, she got to. Early, but I will say, you know, I wasn't talking about Maxwell. You know, he went to New York for whatever he went there for.
That's right.
So, you know, I don't be listening to motherfuckers, but
He
bought me gifts.
Oh my God.
He got me, or us, written lyric book.
You got you and Tyne
from Grandmaster Caz.
Oh my God!
Which is actually signed by Grandmaster Caz.
Oh my God!
It's dope, and it's got like, you know, all his lyrics, had like handwritten lyrics.
That is amazing, right?
That's dope, right?
That is amazing, right there.
Grandmaster Caz,
full out color, like it's just from the book.
And if those who don't know Grandmaster Caz on Cold Crush Brothers, but he's also responsible for the rhymes you hear Big Bang Hank saying in Rapper's Delight. So I was just joking, like after I read this, I'm gonna make Rapper's Delight too, because I'm biting Grandmaster Caz rhymes too. Another thing I got is courtesy of Maxwell Benson. For the baby.
Very nice. Bear claws,
Bear
baby.
Bear claw. I forget the graffiti artist that, you know, Maxwell gets in here. He's going to tell us.
Apparently, again. He's the most famous graffiti artist right now in New York.
Right. So my baby is fly.
Right. Bear claws.
He's doing that shit. So we got that. The gifts just keep on coming. So.
I ain't mad. What else is in there? Wait. Hold up. I know what that is.
What?
They on your eyes.
Oh, yeah, the Casales. You know what I mean? We already talked about that.
Yes.
So rather than talk about all my gifts, I'm going to give you a gift. And you know what that gift is. Kyle.
It's the old school new news with Tyne Teezy.
Thanks, man. This week, according to Hip Hop Wired, the musical play, Holler If You Hear Me, is being characterized as a Broadway flop. The musical, which is based on Tupac's poetry and lyrics, will leave theaters July 20th. So if you're in the New York area, in Times Square, at the Palace, check it out. Young Jock, who is on this season's Love & Hip Hop Atlanta, is actually married. He's been married for 13 years. And has been separated from his wife, Alexandria Robinson, since February of 2012. She is now finally filing for divorce. Bone Thugs and Harmony are planning to reunite and get back on the road for a tour to celebrate their 20th anniversary. Upon completion, they will get back into the studio and record one final album. Shock G, if you're listening, take note. And finally, happy birthday to Jim Jones, who turned 38 today, July 15th. And that's this week's Old School New News on the Going Way Back Show with my man, Money B. And as always, you can find me on all social media at Tyne Teezy. That's TON_TEEZY. And make sure you subscribe to the YouTube channel, The Going Way Back Show. Peace.
Hey, yo, what's up, y'all? Party people, take it easy. You just heard the Old School New News with Tyne Teezy. Take it easy. And I'm DMC.
Yes, he is.
That's right. That's right. DMC in the building.
That was so nice. I like that, Tyne.
Yeah, go you know, Tyne, ahead, Tyne, she put it together. Now, right. If you notice, her voice was a little bit scratchy, right?
Right.
Let me tell you the story behind it. You asked about my weekend.
Right.
So, obviously, it's not from her going into labor with the baby, even though she did do a natural birth, so congratulations.
Yes,
you know what I'm saying?
Yes.
She thugged it out.
Props to that.
She thugged that one out. But the reason that her voice is a little scratchy because while we were in the hospital, you know, we got two little dogs.
Right.
So rather than just leave them out not knowing when we was coming back and forth, I had the idea to leave our back door open. You know, it's got the little thing where they can just come in and out, right? So
right.
Then 2 days.
The little doggy door.
The doggy gate, whatever you want to call it. Well, it turned into a little mousy or ratty gate too.
What?
So, right. So, the other day, to make a long story short, Tyne Teezy came face to face with a young rodent.
Oh,
and
no.
And she lost her fucking mind.
I bet she did.
Man, she jumped on the table. Baby, my baby!
Just letting shots out everywhere.
Oh, my God. So, I mean, that's what we're dealing with, you know what I'm saying, with that. But that's it in a nutshell. So.
Oh, my God. Wow. Really?
So, you guys, we got a great show. Brother Jay from Ace Clan is coming up right after this break. So, stay tuned. It's Going Way Back Show with Money B. We already in full effect. Brother Jay from Ace Clan in the building.
Yes,
Medusa
sir.
Medusa in the building.
Medusa, what's
and my
up?
Brother, tell me your name once again.
Beefy.
Big Beefy. Beefy Love.
Beefy.
What it do?
Beefy.
Well, welcome everybody to the show, man. How y'all doing?
Good, man.
Welcome.
Good time. Now, I got a lot to talk about. You know what I'm saying? Because we go back, and I want to go back and just get into the shit with you. But what I always say is, tell me what's going on with you right now. What are you promoting? I want to get that out the way because I really want to get in your business.
Right.
For real. Talk about
for real,
it.
Right?
Yeah, what's new? What's popping? What they need to go get?
Well, I mean, in 2014, X-Clan is putting forward the first conscious music label called Culture United.
Okay.
And strictly prejudiced toward conscious artists or more so artists that respect the family. You know what I'm saying? We have enough music out here right now that's not respecting family and everything that's all ages is either Disney or Nickelodeon or something.
Right.
So I think there's a platform that we can teach all heads from that could be dope and full of music, and we've been demonstrating that for the past couple years since resurrecting X-Clan. All of our music has been clean and doing whatever on the charts and stars and mics that they need and whatnot. So we just trying to get artists to come in clean off their feet and their robes and whatnot and get into another shift of their career.
Okay. Well, you know, obviously X-Clan, you guys are known, you know, for the messages and the images that you put out there. But tell me about, what was your childhood like? What was you as a, like, was you one of them dudes that was robbing banks and then just all of a sudden decided to turn your life around? Or was you raised right? Was you a pimp like Malcolm X?
That's real. I mean,
you're a smooth brother, man. So I know you did your dirt.
I mean, usually people find knowledge after doing, you know, dirt, but I was blessed to have a good life, man. You know what I'm saying? I was raised in Flatbush, Brooklyn.
Right.
My family taught me honor and respect, and I put that in my music and my poetics when I was DJing and stuff like that. I had to learn how to create a style that would, you know, keep my family tradition alive. You know what I'm saying? I wanted people to feel as good as I was raised, so I didn't have to give them dirt. You know what I'm saying? So and then come clean later on and
so
whatnot.
So it came natural from the beginning to the end.
When it's in your heart, man, you do what's right. Man.
And you just told me something I didn't know. You were a DJ at first.
Yeah, I started as a DJ. I mean, that's where you learn the pockets at. Weren't they all?
Yeah.
I think you were a DJ.
I was a DJ. That's what I'm saying. I think that's where you start. Yeah. So, you know, that being said, what MCs influenced you to become an MC? Like, what was the cast that you was like, yo, I want to be like that?
I like block party MCs because, I mean, and not to call out any names or anything, but I like people who control the block party because you got people walking up from everywhere just off the street who don't like hip hop, and you have to rock, you know what I'm saying, and get them involved and get them to want to stay. So cats who had lyrics and cuts and whatnot who can keep every ethnicity type of audience, you know, in trance, I was amazed by that. So when we were having little block jams and block off the street and whatnot, I was admiring all the cats around my way that was doing it. I admired groups like Stetson Sonic and whatnot, you know, and Force MDs and cats like that who had crews that were known through the boroughs. I like when your name pops out, you know what I'm saying, and people can recognize, you know, before all the status and all of that, the streets buzz your name. You know what I'm saying?
You, it was more, not so much, so it was more about, you know, back then it was about the routines and controlling the crowd.
Exactly.
More so just having a bunch of lyrics.
Master of ceremony is what I was taught when you say MC. So, you know, that was an honor. You know, even for us to step from behind the wheels to grab the mic, it's an honor. You know, it's a different place.
That's right.
Okay, so that being said, when you guys formed X-Clan, you know, and it really took me a minute, don't ask me why, so we're like, wait a minute, there's only one dude rapping. It's like, it's four cats. And then I don't know if anybody's ever seen the X-Clan show. They used to travel with like
a crew.
120 dudes.
They made
120
hammer,
niggas. Just
they
all,
made hammer
they, no, because they had the motherfucker with the flag.
Yeah.
And they had the flamethrowers and the chicks dancing. But you was the MC, so how did you?
I mean,
like,
but,
how did you get approached? Like, you know what? We're gonna start a group, but you gonna be the rapper.
All right. So I mean,
right?
X-Clan joined the movement.
Okay.
Black Watch was the movement, and now you see I'm gonna show you how all the components of X-Clan work out.
Okay.
Professor X was our manager, all right?
Okay.
Architect was our guidance, or you would call A&R.
Okay.
Now, Architect's history with the Latin Quarters, being able to scout talent, know what's good, know what's not, that helped groom what we were bringing to the record label.
Okay.
You know, Lumumba being part of the Black Nationalist Movement, bringing Black Watch, I said, well, look, it would be better for me to bring those brothers into the group rather than me introduce a new Wu-Tang.
Right.
You know, I'm from Flatbush. I can get 50 cats to come and get in the video and look mean and all that kind of stuff, but right. we were able to adopt a movement, you know, okay. or jump into a movement, and they protect us. That's why you say Vanglorious protected.
So before,
Red, Black, and Green.
Before hip hop or outside of hip hop, you guys were a unit anyway.
Yeah, I mean, we joined the school.
Okay.
And that's what people misinterpret, because now the fire breather you're talking about was a Ifa priest. He was an African science.
So I'm going to call him fire breather.
Yeah. but that's what, you know, people looked at our show like a circus.
Okay.
And we had African dancers. We come and splitting the crowd open
right.
in half and coming with the flags. I mean, we brought the Marcus Garvey parade to them. You
right.
know what I'm saying? Well, people didn't see that side of liberation during those years. So we brought a lot of different things that black nationalism was known for mm-hmm. without the prejudice.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? We didn't bring the anger and, you know, this devil this, devil that. No, we celebrated the goodness of being African. And then when you come to the jam and we playing Parliament Funkadelic
right.
and breaks and getting down, now it becomes a parliament of hip-hop.
And I think that's what made you guys stand apart and do so. I want to speak to you about this because, you know, one thing that I always would say is I don't really give a fuck what you're talking about
right.
as long as it's dope.
Right.
You feel me?
Exactly.
You can have a message. If you got a message and you whack, I'm not going to hear your message.
At all.
You know what I mean? So you guys were, I guess, one of the few that really, really pulled that thing together.
Yes.
So let me ask you, what was a recording session like? With Professor X.
Right?
And the reason I ask, because you know, as an MC, you know, we get in the booth, right? And we like,
Brother,
oh, wait, hold on, run that back.
Yeah,
so it was a nigga like, yo, ring that back. Was he fucking up the lines? Like, did he write it down? How'd that go?
It was deep. That's funny you say that, man, because PX took the Russell Simmons approach in the back of the room. He would be in the corner right there.
Right.
Architect would probably be at the board. Now, the biggest fight that me and Architect would have in the studio is Architect like beat machines.
Right.
And I like breaks.
Okay.
All right. So we would argue, like, if I sample Roy Ayers, I'm not going to put a Dr. Rhythm or SB-12. Boom, boom, boom.
Underneath.
I want to put a drum pattern from Bill Withers or something
right.
else. I want to, you know, collage.
You know, let me ask you a question about that real quick, not to interrupt you, but in Grand Verbalizer, was that Fela Kuti? Did you guys sample
yes.
that, or did you have somebody re-say that?
No, Filet. I sampled that.
You sampled that?
Fela Kuti.
There you go. Yeah, that,
yeah.
Yes.
That shit was dope.
That was dope.
And that's better than me faking or putting some corny drums. Look,
right.
we'll be talking about a song 20 years from now.
Right.
And what I did was apply my DJing to the studio. I'd never been in a studio in my life.
Yeah.
But I know what mixed together.
Exactly.
Yeah, and I know he had various breakbeats, volume 1 through 23,
because
he used every single one of them.
And you know what?
Every record.
Those are expensive to use, man. I
right.
stopped using those.
Yeah, guys, I know you did now.
Yeah, they were dope though.
Really, really quick, we got a call on the line.
That's what's up.
Call, are you there?
Yes.
Peace.
Yo, who that?
Hello.
Yeah, how you doing?
Hello? Hey, good evening. How you doing?
Respect.
Who's calling?
My name is Coletti. I'm calling from Maryland.
Okay, what's happening? You got a word for Brother Jay?
Yeah, how you doing? Is this Money B?
Yes, this is.
Hey, how you doing, sir? How you doing, Brother Jay?
Peace, brother.
What's happening?
Peace. I had a quick question. Right now, we're seeing a lot of the Eye of Horus everywhere in the videos and everywhere, and people are associating that with the Illuminati. Do you think that's an incorrect representation of it, or how do you feel about that?
Well, of course. I mean, two different sides of the pool, you know what I'm saying? I think that, you know, a lot of people are trying to get with symbolics and things without doing their homework. You know, it's a lot of ghetto knowledge right now going on, a lot of assumption and self-proclamation going on, so you'll get that. You know what I'm saying? Google's not going to tell you the true science. You got to go talk to some of them elders and get up the computer for 5 minutes, and they'll correct you.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? So, you know, when you see that, you see these little blasts on these internet you put on there, you know, go talk to the elder, you know, and stop Googling.
Right.
I think it'll fix up.
Keep
talk
it real.
To your elders.
We appreciate your call, man. So we're going to take a break. Come right back. Medusa, Brother Jay.
Be float.
I'm going to get it right.
LB.
Right here on the Going Way Back Show with Money B. Jay.
Big thing.
Producer.
Drop.
What's going on with you, baby girl? How you doing?
Man, I'm full of love, and it's all manifesting in the right way.
That's
now,
right.
Every time I look up, I always see you making moves and doing something. I think one of the last things that I sent you in was a song and video with Mellow Man Ace and his son Gazelle. So what's new with you? What's popping?
Man, I'm actually working on a project right now with Aloe Black. We start recording again in September.
Okay.
I'm also working with Brother Jay on quite a few collaborations in his label situation. You know what I'm saying?
Word.
Also, I just finished up Corsets and Cufflinks, and I got Battle Cat on a couple of tracks on that. That's retarded.
How is Battle Cat?
Oh, he's wonderful, man. Okay. He's good since he had that incident.
Okay,
he's really
straight?
Good. Yeah.
Okay.
And you know, I got a dope feature with Glasses on that project. That's pretty sick. It got Where's the DJ Booth? That's out right now from One Wise Productions.
Nice.
It's got a lot of heavyweight DJs on that, from Fat Jack to, I mean, I got MC Light on a track. Brother Jay just told me,
Light be putting it down.
Hey, no, but this is the coldest Light has sounded in years.
Oh, she sound hungry?
Trust, I know Light. Light's been putting it down. I know Light. She's,
can't sleep on Light.
She never slips.
But I like to say, you can't sleep on you. And this is a question for both of you guys, because you're an OG and a legend out here in L.A. doing your thing. But do you got one, and it's for both of you, but for two different reasons. You, as a female, putting in work and just doing your thing, and you, as sometimes maybe having your content overshadowing the actual skills and the flavor that you actually have as an MC, and you be a woman, like, do you guys ever feel slighted in any way that people aren't recognizing you for the skills that you actually do have?
For what, like, you actually really are?
You know what I mean? But, you know, like, you see a lot of cats get on, you be like, yeah, he's nice, but, you know what I'm saying? I'm nicer than that.
For real.
I think in both, I mean, even speaking for the sister, it stands exceptional, regardless. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? You know, it matters how you present your situation, man. You know, I came as a messenger. I didn't want to be MC, whatever. I didn't want to battle Cool J. I didn't want to do none of that. You know what I'm saying? I didn't want that. You know, part of the messenger thing is to sacrifice a lot of ego. You know what I'm saying?
And
And I'm sure for a woman, she has to sacrifice the ego of competing with men and just to be herself.
Yes.
You know what I'm saying? Yes. So that sacrifice can go a long way, man, and keep you on the table for longevity like we are here, man.
Yeah. All right. So, and speaking of ego, a question about things that are happening now. Because, you know, what I see, and I've had conversations with different people, is, you know, this beef, you know, people having beef. Like, there's always been beef in hip-hop, you know, back in the day, and I'm sure each of you have had your episodes with different artists, as well as myself. But now I see a trend of, and maybe it's the technology, where cats are, like, beefing on social media and airing each other out. You know, in 140 characters.
That's a sad
What's your take on that? And beef, you could chime in if you want to on that. Cause
thank you very much.
And,
look,
in my opinion, like,
that's my question.
You got two mics.
And just to add to it, I always say, like, if you're a man, talk to a man if you got a problem.
Yeah, but see, that's the thing about reality. Look, let me explain something to y'all. You do not know who you're talking to when you're keen in what you're saying.
Right.
Typing in "I'm going to do something to you" is not tough.
That ain't gangster.
That's not gangster. That's childish, and it's evidence.
Well, I always say teenagers and women.
The best ass whoopings are by surprise.
Yes.
You get what I'm saying?
No, for real.
Whether you win or lose, and you didn't know it was coming.
Right.
And you dealt with
that
right.
Exactly.
That is for
but see, you guys need to understand that. It's becoming too much of a control.
Yes.
You understand the wrong people are getting power with this thing. And the attention's being taken away from what's important. What's important is this. Good morning, my brother. How are you doing? I love you. Right. We don't touch each other anymore.
Right.
Right.
A child actually texts their mom.
That's from the next room.
They ain't no hugs no more.
Yeah, and the reason I brought it up, because the whole thing with Meek Mill and Wale, like, if this cat is supposed to be part of your crew, but y'all talking about each other on social media.
Y'all got to remember that you cannot get back what you type. That's the difference between a word, bro. You can't get back what you type.
Got that right. Excuse me, brother. Say it one more time. One more time.
You cannot get back what you type. You can always forgive someone for what they say.
That's right.
But listen, if I could wake up in the morning and you said it and I wasn't there and read it,
right?
Of course I'm going to whoop your ass for it.
Brother Jay, you want to add to that? Any thoughts on it?
Bro, I just think cats are running out of things to say, man. You know what I'm saying? And they creating these little wars and all of this thing, man. I don't get entertained by that. These cats make too much money to be beefing, man.
Right.
To you don't know what to do with that paper,
thank
man.
You.
Pass that back.
And just, and
the reality.
Putting all your business out there for everybody to check it out. Now, we do have a caller on the line, so let's chime in. Caller, you on the air? Who is it and where you calling from?
Yo, what's up? Hector Garcia, representing Save the Hip Hop Culture, calling from Southern Cali.
Peace.
What it do?
What's going on?
Respect.
What's poppin'?
Respect, peace, and blessings. Just want to say what's up, first and foremost, Medusa, Money B, Brother J. I got a question for Brother J, though.
What's up, brother?
My man. I've been seeing you've been, obviously, you know, throughout your career, knowledge and wisdom is the main goal that you, with when you were with S-Clan and Solo, obviously, knowledge and wisdom, kind of like the law of hip-hop. And I noticed that you posted stuff here and there saying you want to get back to getting lecture out and all the good stuff. I just want to see if that is the making, because hip-hop really needs it at this point.
You need to get your phone fixed, bro.
I'm sorry, you kind of broke up. Did you understand what he said?
Yeah, I understood what he said. Okay. You were breaking up, brother, but it's just a balance. You know what I'm saying? I'm not trying to pushed a conscious wave to erase what it is, you know, that's going on, because that wouldn't be balanced. You know what I'm saying? But, you know, if there's 24 hours in a day, give us at least 6 hours to make an impression as well, to give people another option. It shouldn't be monopolized to just be one thing. That's all I'm trying to kick.
True.
You feel me? I don't want to hear, I listen to music that's happening nowadays. I mean, you got to go with the evolution of things. You know what I'm saying? You can't be a sore loser, so to speak, just because our era didn't last into, you know, what Rihanna has or mm-hmm. Chris Brown or whatever. You know that.
Nice.
We shouldn't be bitter
at all.
You know what I'm saying? But we should still fight for a balance. You know what I'm saying? For all the kids that sit in the back seat coming from school, that got to come to a power station playing stripper club music. You know what I'm saying? We got, you know, the program directors kind of got to put themselves in position to say, you know, family time, party time.
Right.
So, you know, that's what we're trying to impress. So I hope that knowledge and wisdom can manifest in that way and balance. So we're not an enemy. You know, hip-hop should be one.
That's peace.
How you like that? All right, man. Well, thanks for calling in. You take care, all right?
Appreciate it.
So we got to go on the break. But before we do, we got a game that we play here on the Going Way Back show. And it's, you know, you all would say that you pretty much, you know your hip-hop, don't you? But we got a game, it's called Who Said It?
Okay.
Right? So what we do is, we give you a line from a song, and you have to tell us who said it and what song it came from. Now, normally, Tontese is here, and she reads it. Now,
and there's no cadence
to it
at
all. What's fun about
when
Tontese reads it, because she's not hip-hop at all.
Okay.
So when she reads it, you have no idea.
Okay.
So I'm going to try to say the line without giving it up.
Okay.
And let me see what y'all know. Y'all ready to play this game?
Yeah,
now, normally we play. We got like a little dope intro that Maxwell made. But since we got to go on a break, I'm just going to run it. This is the first one. Y'all ready?
Ready.
Okay. Now, this should be pretty easy. Then I got another one. I like to think of myself as a pure rebel, a radical thinker on a musical level.
KRS-One.
I was gonna say the same.
No.
Thing.
Can I get it? Can I get
what?
It? No, can I? No, can I get the?
Wait, what? I'm sorry.
You fucked up the boom.
I thought you were reading
now
the first
you're
one.
With my emotions.
I thought you. I'm playing with your emotions. Here we go. You ready?
Yes.
That ain't it, fool.
You gave me. Wait. No. Which one did you give me?
You fucking up my game.
You gave me two.
Right,
fucking up my game.
Those are the two that were on the email.
That sounded like KRS-One.
It wasn't KRS-One.
No.
It was D-Nice. It was close. Play it. That's what I'm saying.
That's what I'm saying, dog. I had the right one.
No, you didn't.
Yes, I did.
I'll tell you. We're going to go to break. And we're going to come back. Go way back, show me.
Wrote that.
This is the last segment, so that we don't run out of time, I want you to, everybody, say what, you know, your social media handles is and where people can find you if they want to reach you for whatever reason.
No doubt, producer.
I'm at thegangstagoddess.com, thegangstagoddess.com. You can catch all my links on that. Or you can hit me on Twitter, Legend Medusa, or Instagram, Legend Medusa, and Facebook, Medusa Cali Frame, as in your body frame, as in your frame of mind.
I'm at simple, at BroJXClan, BroJXClan, and you can check us out. Our Facebook page is XClan Worldwide, but Instagram, Twitter, at BroJXClan. Respect.
Okay, Dave.
Yeah, Beefy Loke from Eastside Long Beach is definitely in the building, my brother. Yeah, Money
B. He's an Eastsider.
Yes, sir.
Eastsider rider.
Feel me? Long Beach VIP Records on PCH and Martin Luther King is where you will find me.
Huh.
562-591-2349. My Facebook is Beefy Loke. It's just a stiller patch because I'm not with all the pictures. If you want to find me, please come to PCH of Martin Luther King, VIP Records is still open forever.
Wow, Long Beach, really?
Real talk, Long Beach is definitely in the
building. Y'all still rocking vinyl or what?
Yes, we are, sir. And we would love for you to come by because
man,
we
you know,
love
you. I'll be there.
We love
nice.
You. We love you.
Remember the last time I was down there?
No, sir, because I think I was on a state pay vacation.
Oh, well. You missed it. I was down there.
I know you was because I seen all the pictures.
Yeah, it was
you
like,
know what I'm saying?
It's been a while, though. It was like the late 90s, I would like to say. Now, we're going to get out of here since I got such elite MCs in the crib. You know, always, whenever I get a chance to get a hot freestyle, you know, I'm going for it.
You do
so,
some acapellas, man. Let's do some acapellas.
You know, acapella, you want to rock off a beat?
Yeah, man.
It's your choice. What you
want
to do?
I got lyricists in the place. I want Cass to hear every word.
I got the beat.
He wanted
okay,
the
well,
lyrics.
Okay, well, then spit it then. We let you go. Medusa, what you want?
Yeah,
yo,
man. It don't matter
to me.
Okay. He got the beatbox.
I got the beatbox.
Wow, man.
That's whatever
beatbox,
you do.
Man. Just come and hit him in the head.
Yeah.
Hit him in the head.
It's exclusive. Brother J and Medusa freestyle.
Hit him low.
Why are you standing on the corner? Folding nothing. Why are you standing on the corner? Folding nothing.
See, you was looking for love in the streets, held those remedies. I was holding a grudge, dissing slugs. You remember me. Out thugging with the homies, late night cracking brews and bliss. I was praying for a blessing in the midst of this bush.
God's on your side.
Yellow, but I'm riding, and I'm bucking the busters down. But in my heart, tears crying. Thoughts of suicide, I've been denied by the streets. Welcome home, young pillar, says death at this life's door.
Block love. Beef Loke.
Yeah. Jay.
Go ahead, Medusa. Go ahead, big.
He's like, I'm gonna shut it down.
Yeah. See, I'm feeling chilling.
Yeah. I like that. Go ahead, Medusa.
You know, I come from where real heads got hip hop sprung. We ain't all about that dumb. But I'm not trying to say I'm bitter. Or else I wouldn't be playing the game in the social network. Hit me on my Twitter. And if you don't feel like doing that, you can hit me on my number. I still got one of those. 213-523-900. Uh-oh. What is it that you want from me? A Facebook, a display, or how a bitch wanna not wanna be me? Don't even be that. I want you to be that attack in black on that microphone. Me, I'm gonna be the ones and twos and the chrome. You better spit on me hard. If not, your flames ain't gonna retard properly. Me, I'm in this hip hop because I got them flocking, see? Flocking G to G from West Coast to She to Shining She. And that was a freestyle straight from Medusa, the W-E-S-T.
Jay, shut it down.
Wow. Check. Burn down the barn when I flex degrees. Baton of fire in the hands of a G.
Pure sick of reading melody, no matter what they're telling me. I'm building with the roots to the end of me. 10,000 leagues from my enemies. I'm pedaling quickly, stepping to a different type of synergy. The study is deepening, opening a barrel of abilities. My agility drums, antiquity bass. The man in the mirror is the sphinx with the nose on his face. The kingdom come with the drum and the bass. You know I get beasts in the place. With the syllable haste, I cut chase, waste time or none. Till the song gets done, you know I'm down for fun. I capture and kick it like Donkey Kong. Ring the alarm, pass the dochi. Greedy ain't me, but we gonna eat hearty. In the house, we start the party like Vanglorious swag and Garveyites. Green rapping, blonde in mind. 24-7, 365, they walk alive anywhere, anytime. Any technique I speak is straight shine. King of the jungle, golden drine. Greystoke stroke, call of the wild. Gorilla dawn and they couldn't get realer. Never sold out, so they called me McGilla. Mm. Deliverer of my slivers who spill it.
He outspit his own tongue.
Yeah. I was like,
yeah.
Like, that's what the fuck I'm talking about. Now, you know, y'all came with it. Now, what do you think about some of today's artists? Like, what are your thoughts on like Iggy Azalea?
I mean, you know,
Iggy Azalea, the white chick from Australia. That's doing her thing.
I feel like she could repeat a ghost track really nice.
A ghost track.
Chuck D called her out for saying nigga.
Oh, yeah. Can we all call that out?
No, you don't think?
Y'all didn't stone Gwyneth Paltrow.
I don't think. Well, I heard that it wasn't. She didn't really say it. That somebody.
It was written, but she had to recite it. So she
oh, she
did
said
say
it.
She sounds just like T.I. when she spits.
Oh yeah, I know.
So that ghost track she sent her, she did that quite well.
Right.
Well, yeah, you can hear T.I. all over it, and that's the thing about it. So what MCs or what groups or who's out that you guys are?
Is anybody
right now
sparking your mind right now? Out now.
I still like D Block, man. Jada Kissing them is holding it down. So.
Yeah. Nice. Okay.
I'm on Kendrick right now, but you know, that's cool.
I mean, I'm still kind of wooing. You know, I'm a master killer. I'm ghosting. You know what I'm
saying? And Slaughterhouse is ill too, so.
Yeah, Slaughterhouse.
You fuck with all the whole battle shit with Hollow Down and all them?
I'm trying to get a crew together to go get against those champions.
My man.
Oh, word?
Yeah.
Come on now.
They won't see her.
We got
chops.
What you
mean by Kendrick?
Don't make me chop.
Kendrick.
Impressive.
I like him.
I like his show too. I like his live show.
I hope they don't give him no quirky D12 tracks and whatnot. You know, sometimes they
second
do that to
album,
balance off the hill.
That
they need
album
to let him go.
Yeah, that second album is going to be. It's kind of nervous right now.
Oh, don't say that.
We don't know.
Oh, you heard it?
No, I haven't heard it. I haven't heard anything. I just don't know. You know, people coming out with their second albums and people.
I mean, he was coming too hard. You know, they try to water it down.
Right, exactly.
Yeah, man.
Exactly. He'd be like, hey, dude, we can't accept that.
Or they want you to repeat it.
The mixtape saved him anyway, man.
Well, that's man, right. I appreciate you guys all coming on and hanging out with your boy.
Hey,
you know
man
what I'm saying? You're welcome anytime. Oh, yeah. You know what? I forgot to tell you the story that I was going to tell you.
Oh.
Before we get out of here, I got a funny story. Like I said, we did a song with X-Clan a long time ago. This was like 19.
Close the crack house.
Yeah, close the crack house.
Wow.
Right.
Wow.
I was a Public Enemy, a Big Daddy Kane. Who else was on that joint?
College Boy.
So anyway,
everybody.
Y'all came out to Oakland to record. So before we start the session, Professor X, he calls me outside, right? And he's all like, brother. And he's all like, he said, before
brother,
we.
Brother, brother, brother.
He's like, before we venture into this plus one and. You know, we need to get together and we need to. And he's just talking to me and I'm looking at him. And I didn't know what he said. And so I look at him and I was like, want some weed? He went, yes, brother.
We need to roll some weed.
Time for some libation, brother.
Right, you know,
libation.
We got some space, my brother. He had a long ass speech and I was like, all you had to do was tell him you want some weed. That's all I got, man. You know, follow me on all social media at MoneyB69. Make sure you subscribe to the YouTube channel, the Going Way Back Show. Follow the Going Way Back Show on Twitter at Going Way Back Show.
Please.
Always. Tell them real quick.
Are always at Instagram and always in your ear on Twitter.
And check out the podcast on the Going Way Back Show
Big Up DJ
website.
Always.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you all for coming through.
Everybody in the hip-hop
Maxwell
game,
Benson.
Please be responsible for your music. Drive safely.
Yes, sir.
Maxwell Info. We out,
Maxwell
y'all.
Info.
Till next time.
Doing the
be
most.
Easy.
It's the Going Way Back Show with Money B. classic hip-hop, raw and uncut.
Thanks for visiting the Going Way Back Show channel. Make sure you rate, comment, and subscribe, and click that like button.